I've got the top of the hour, and as we're only scheduled for a half hour here this morning, we're gonna get started. I'd like to welcome everyone. I hope you're all having a good day. I'd like to thank you all for taking time out of your day to join this webinar. I'm your host, Corey Schneider, a business development manager with Presto Geosystems. I've been with Presto for 14 years and have extensive experience with all of the products and applications we will be covering today. We manufacture erosion control, stormwater management, and porous pavement products and are located in northern Wisconsin. All of our products are manufactured right here in Wisconsin and sold through a local distribution network throughout the country and the world. So today our focus is going to be on dams, dikes, levees, and spillways. We'll learn how the GEOWEB system can protect against erosion from water flow in a variety of project conditions, how geocells can accommodate typical construction issues and design challenges, and how GEOWEB can reduce vertical pressure on subgrades to allow for a reduced cross-section in load support applications. Everyone is muted for the webinar, so if you do have any questions during the presentation, please type them into the question window and I will address them at the end. First, a little background on Presto. We actually worked with the Army Corps of Engineers to develop geocell technology back in the late 70s and have been innovating ever since. Our products have been used in over 200 countries and in every state in the U.S. And we do pride ourselves in going beyond simply providing a product. We have a lot of design and construction resources available on our website or with a simple phone call to our main phone number. We've got experienced engineers on staff. And we do offer free project design evaluations. So with some very limited inputs on your project specifics, we can provide specific recommendations as to the type of GEOWEB we would recommend that you use, as well as how to anchor it in whatever application you're working on. We do provide contractor support as well, so we have installation manuals and videos available on our website. We also have local support. So someone from Presto or our local distributor can show up on the project site at the beginning of construction to not only make sure that the product is installed correctly, but also that it's installed as efficiently as possible. Generally speaking, we operate in three product areas: soil stabilization using our GEOWEB geocells, which can be used for load support, slope and channel protection, and constructing green retaining walls. We've got a porous pavement line, both vegetated and aggregate solutions. And then we also have some lightweight reusable construction mats. Today though, we're going to focus on the GEOWEB specifically, with the main focus being on slope and hydraulic performance, but we'll also cover load support applications briefly. We'll start out with a little bit of general information about the GEOWEB geocells, just to give you a little background for those of you who aren't familiar with them. The GEOWEB system consists of two main attributes. The first is the infill type, which we'll get to in a moment. The second is the cell or container size. The cells come in three different diameters, 8 by 9 inches, 11 by 12 inches, and 18 by 20 inches. And each one of those cell sizes can come in 3, 4, 6, or 8 inch depths. The specific cell size, cell depth combination is going to depend on the project details and loading requirements if we've got a load support applications. The seam strength is very important to the function of the geocell. The stronger the seam strength, the better the geocell will function. A strong seam will allow for heavier infill material and better lifetime performance. The strength of the panel material, in our case, virgin high-density polyethylene is also critical to the strength and performance of a geocell system. As mentioned earlier, GEOWEB can be used for load support, slope and channel protection, and green wall construction. Shown here are some representative cell sizes and cell depths for typical uses. So this table is just a general representation for summary purposes. We do recommend that you use our free project evaluation service to make sure that you use the proper cell size and cell depth combination for your application. A typical GEOWEB panel is going to come trifolded and palletized. Each section has a nominal width of 8.5 feet with lengths up to 58 feet. The panels are flexible, opening like an accordion, so they can follow the natural contours of the work site without being confined to a rigid set of dimensions. They can also easily be field cut to accommodate any dimensions that you need. The GEOWEB is equipped with numerous design and construction components that increase the strength and speed of the installation. So on the left-hand side here, we have our different staking options. Up on top is the address stake clip. So that typically is going to fit on a half inch or number 4 diameter rebar. And then one of those arms simply hooks over the cell wall to give you a good solid connection between your anchor and the GEOWEB panels. If you're worried about the rebar corroding over time in saltwater applications or highly acidic soils, we can provide a fiberglass anchor or an all-plastic stake, both of which are, of course, will be corrosion-proof. And using any one of our anchoring options, we do have a GAD that works with either a Hilti or other type of pneumatic driver, so that it fits snugly over that Atrus stake clip, and it allows you to very quickly drive in the stakes without having to pound them all in individually. For connecting the sections together side to side and end to end, we've developed this Atra key, which is a very simple little plastic H basically. And this is going to replace the old method of a stapled connection. The Atra key is going to give you 3 times the connection strength. Being made out of plastic, it's not going to rust, so it will prevent future failures. It's also going to be about twice as fast to install as stapling and will not require any tools on the job site. Another anchoring option besides stakes is to use a tendon system. So with those tendons, which are basically just flat ropes, we provide what we call the Atra tendon clip, which is going to distribute the loads throughout the entire system. And as you can see from these photos, it's got a turn and lock installation. You simply wrap the tendon around the post, and it's going to give you a secure connection that will allow for pre-assembly, which will save time. And I'll show you an example of that a little bit later on. But many times it will allow you to assemble the entire piece of GEOWEB with the tendons on the top of the slope so that you can minimize the amount of time that workers actually have to be on the slope. So we'll look at some application-specific uses of the GEOWEB system, starting with the armoring of dams, dikes, and levees. A typical earthen dam or dike application might look something like this. On the wet side, we'd have GEOWEB armoring, generally with an aggregate or concrete infill, with that infill type mostly dependent on wave action as well as drawdown rates. The cells could then be expanded over the top of the dike and down the dry side. This would provide a stable driving surface at the crest, so we'd infill with aggregate typically up on top. Then on the dry side, we could transition to a topsoil vegetation solution. This will allow for natural aesthetics while still providing erosion protection should the dam overtop. I mentioned that GEOWEB could be used to stabilize the crest of dams or levees to create a drivable surface, which would be a load support application. So we'll get just a little bit more in depth on that application first. The GEOWEB three-dimensional system works this way for load support applications. When a vertical load is applied, the active earth pressure in the loaded cell pushes back against the passive earth pressure in the adjacent cell to form a stable system. Each cell helps support the ones around it. The GEOWEB cell walls transfer hoop stress, which is important in keeping the system intact and creates a mattress effect. The strength of the seams around each cell, the material properties of the individual strips, and the connection method between panels are all important factors in determining how the GeoCell system can improve load-bearing capacity. So strong seams, semi-ductile resin properties, and integrated connections are critical to a well-performing system. And the GEOWEB system and accessories are specifically designed to work together to be an effective solution for load support applications, specifically in soft soil locations. Here you can see the stresses on the subgrade with the unsupported subgrade on the left and GEOWEB reinforcement on the right. Notice how there is a complete elimination of the highest stresses at the top of the subgrade with GEOWEB reinforcement. The stresses are reduced and distributed over a wider area, which again we call the mattress effect. And this mattress effect reduces the stress reaching the subgrade and leads to a significant decrease in deflection and rutting. The top schematic here, we've got unconfined aggregate, which will move down and out, leading to a lot of maintenance when you load it with a vehicle. We're also not utilizing the full strength of the aggregate as it's able to move around. By adding GEOWEB to the section, which we show on the bottom, we'll greatly reduce maintenance through confinement. There's nowhere for the aggregate to go, and it will give additional strength to the infill by adding apparent cohesion, allowing us to reduce section depth. So, quick summary of load support benefits. We are going to be able to reduce your aggregate cross section by 70% or more. We'll control lateral and vertical infill movement, which will prevent shearing, and we create a stiff base with a high flexural strength. On to using GEOWEB in slope protection, which is what reinforced dam and levee faces are. Here we see what a typical section might look like, showing some of the anchoring options, including stakes and the tendon dead man system. So notice we're showing a geosynthetic underlayment here. Typically we would use that with either a concrete or aggregate infill, but if we're filling with topsoil, we would try to stay away from that geotextile as we don't want to impede root growth into the subgrade, which will lead to better long-term erosion resistance. We show stakes here, and usually those are going to be put in some sort of a pattern, which our engineers will give to you, and we'll tell you to do it every, say, third cell across and fifth cell down the slope, or some sort of combination. And then if we can't use stakes, which typically are difficult to use on very long steep slopes or over geomembranes, that's when we use the tendon system. So here we're showing the tendon buried or tied to a dead man pipe that's buried at the crest. And if you don't have room for that dead man pipe, we can give you a calculation that will tell you the pullout resistance of an earth anchor that would be required. So you could just tie each individual tendon to an earth anchor and drive those into the ground. GEOWEB is an economical alternative to large riprap and reinforced concrete for dam faces and spillways, and can even allow for vegetated faces that otherwise would not be possible due to the hydraulic forces at play. If rock is used, GEOWEB allows you to greatly reduce the rock size, and with concrete, we can cut the required concrete depth in half when compared to reinforced concrete solutions. With the GEOWEB vegetation option, topsoil confined in the cells and covered with a turf reinforcement mat can withstand very high velocities and shear stresses and can replace large riprap or concrete in many cases. How do we know this? We tested the system at Colorado State University in their hydraulics lab using 6-inch GEOWEB filled with topsoil, covered with a mid-grade turf reinforcement mat and in a fully vegetated state. And it actually achieved some pretty amazing results. That combination system was able to withstand 29 feet per second and 16 pounds of shear without failure, which is more than twice the hydraulic resistance of 12-inch riprap and about double the performance of a high-performance turf reinforcement mat alone. The combination system works because the turf reinforcement mat provides cover for the GEOWEB, so there's no scouring of the cells. And the GEOWEB will confine the soil below the turf reinforcement mat so it doesn't wash downstream when saturated, which is how TRMs alone fail. We also tested this system in an unvegetated condition and found that GEOWEB improves the hydraulic performance of a turf reinforcement mat alone by about 30%. We also tested an aggregate infill, also at Colorado State. Here we did three different cell sizes, two different rock sizes, and ran a total of 90 tests. So with the high number of data points, this allowed for the creation of a regression equation. So with this equation, we're able to perform analysis, and given the bed slope and unit discharge of any hydraulic situation, we can manipulate the rock size and the cell size until we get a rock loss L of zero. And when we compare our rock sizing tools to the traditional ones of Abson Johnson and the Corps of Engineers, we find that through confinement, we're able to reduce your rock size anywhere from 2 to 10 times, which can lead to significant savings, not only in your rock cost, but also transportation and installation costs as well. The final infill we'll look at is concrete. It can be poured in place with no additional forms or reinforcement, as the GEOWEB cell walls act as both. Confinement also allows for the use of easier to place high slump concrete and assures uniform concrete depth. Generally, we just specify a 3,000 to 4,000 PSI concrete. That's really the only limitations. And again, a 3-inch concrete filled GEOWEB can typically replace 5 to 6-inch depth of reinforced concrete, of course, leading to pretty significant savings. Once anchored, the GEOWEB allows the concrete to be either pumped or poured right into the cells. And then we simply screed and finish to the top of the cell walls. Notice on the right-hand photo the flexibility of the system. Once that concrete has cured, it's very flexible because each cell wall is basically going to be a joint. So this will greatly reduce cracking that occurs on the system. Again, we had some very impressive results for the concrete-filled version at Colorado State. Mid-sized cell, 3 inches deep, withstood 36 feet per second and 21 pounds of shear. And again, we maxed out the flume rather than failed the system. So now we'll go over a few case studies, the first one being Mud Lake Dam in Gardnerville, Nevada. This was a 100-year-old earthen dam that no longer met safety standards and needed to be rehabilitated. A cost-effective alternative to traditional reinforced concrete was needed. The selected solution involved a 16-ounce non-woven geotextile, 45-mil polypropylene geomembrane, another 16-ounce non-woven, and then 3-inch concrete-filled GEOWEB anchored with tendons and a dead man pipe. Of course, we used the tendon system to avoid puncturing the liner. So in the photos here, we see the geomembrane being placed over the geotextile. And the geomembrane, of course, provides an impermeable waterproof barrier that will prevent saturation of the earthen structure. As I mentioned earlier, we can do some pre-assembly here. So in this case, the tendons and load transfer clips were placed within the GEOWEB sections in assembly areas off slope. This will minimize the amount of time the contractor has to spend on the slope, increasing both speed and safety. With the 3-inch GEOWEB layer as a form, concrete is expediently placed over the entire 2-to-1 slope. The concrete was poured into the cells near the crest and pumped into the cells in the areas further from the crest. The GEOWEB alternative cost about $10 a square foot installed and offered cost savings of around $600,000 over the 90,000 square foot project. So that was savings of about $6.67 a square foot, or 40% when compared to traditional reinforced concrete. Moving on to a vegetated solution on the dry side of a dam. This here is Lake Hefner Dam in Oklahoma. It experienced pretty significant erosion damage along the bank and under the road on the dry side over a number of years from overtopping and sheet flow from the roadway. Excessive rains and high winds contributed to the overtopping issues that caused erosion on the opposite side of the roadway. The lake side of the dam is protected from erosion by placement of new riprap here. And then again, on the dry side, they use the GEOWEB slope protection system to prevent future soil erosion and sloughing. The system was placed on the 2-to-1 roadway embankments and anchored with Atra stakes. And here we see the final result. We've got a fully vegetated GEOWEB slope protection system that will provide long-term erosion protection. Here we've got Hickory Mound impoundment in Florida. It's an example of a concrete-filled GEOWEB dam or causeway. And with the concrete-filled GEOWEB covering both the slopes and the crest of the dam, a smooth drivable surface was created at the top. Spillways are also fairly common applications, so we'll just look at a few examples of those quickly. Here we've got 4-inch concrete filled GEOWEB utilized at this medical complex in Tallahassee, Florida. Approximately 460 square yards was used for the flume and another 230 square yards for the spillway apron. And this spillway empties into a holding pond that is designed to capture runoff for the entire 82-acre development. One more example of a hard armored GEOWEB spillway. This one's at a country club in Pennsylvania. I mentioned earlier that no forms were needed when using concrete filled GEOWEB, but you'll notice here that they did put a form board on the edges of the GEOWEB installation, and this is going to allow them to create a nice straight line at the edge. Again, the benefits of using concrete-filled GEOWEB for applications like this is that you can reduce the concrete depth, you don't need any additional forms or reinforcement, and its flexible nature will handle some differential settlement. All in all, it's a much more economical solution than reinforced concrete. So today we looked at some innovative solutions for dams, dikes, levees, and spillways. Before we get to the questions, I do want to remind you that we provide a complete solution, and part of that is our technical assistance. The engineering team here at Presto Geosystem works closely with engineers, offering a free project evaluation service for any roads, embankment, or erosion control project. The form is on our website, which is prestogeo.com. Should only take you about 10 minutes to complete. And we do ask for a lot of information. You can fill it out with as much information as you have. The less information, the more conservative our recommendation will be, but it we can use it as a starting point as well. And you can also attach documents such as geotechnical reports when you submit the form as well. It will then come into the engineering team here at Presto. And within 3 business days, but usually faster, we can provide a complete design evaluation, including infill recommendations, anchorage requirements, and backing calculations. We will work with you to get you the best design for your project. I'd like to thank all of you for attending today. Here's my contact information. If there are any questions that come up later, please feel free to send me an email. We'll be sending you a follow-up email in the next few days, and it will be a link to this recorded webinar that's going to be on our YouTube channel. You can share this with others who may have missed this presentation, or you can use it for review in the future. And you'll also get instructions for receiving your certificate for the half PDH credit that you've earned for attending today. Now I'll check the questions box and take care of anything that came up during the course of the presentation. The slide indicates that there are 5 depths available, but only 4 are listed. Yes, that is true. We do make a 12-inch depth as well. That's more of a custom-made material, but it can be done. So actually, the options are 3, 4, 6, 8, and 12-inch depths. What filling was used on the wet side? I'm not sure if you're talking which actual project you're talking about, but typically on the wet side, it's going to be either aggregate or concrete. And again, that will depend on what sort of wave action we have on the wet side, as well as what sort of drawdown there might be. Is there a max horizontal vertical slope for vegetated aggregate and concrete infill for a sport spillway application? I'm wondering about using it on 2-to-1 slopes. Really, as long as your slope is globally stable, I would say with vegetation and concrete, there is really no limiting slope. You know, those are going to be very stable. The concrete, as soon as it cures, the vegetation, as soon as the vegetation grows in full. With aggregate, there certainly will be effective limitations. The steeper the side slope, the more apt the aggregate will be to wash downstream. We can run calculations, but for a spillway, which I would assume is typically going to have reasonably high velocities, I would say nothing more than 3-to-1 for an aggregate spillway, but really no effective limits for vegetation and concrete. Do you recommend a standard Manning's coefficient for a gravel GEOWEB surface, or does it vary with stone size? Yeah, I mean, the GEOWEB itself really will not have any effect on the Manning's coefficient. So whatever the Manning's coefficient is for the size of stone that we use is going to be the one that will be applicable with it in the geocells. So that looks like all of the questions. We've got 1 minute left in our half hour. I'll hang out here for a minute, see if any other questions come up. But I do want to thank you for attending, and be on the lookout for that email, which will let you know how to get your PDH credit and also give you a link to this recorded webinar. So thanks again. Hopefully you'll join us for another webinar in the future. And if you do have any questions, you can still see my email there, cory.schneider@prestogeo.com. And definitely check out our website at prestogeo.com, which has a lot of information available on it. Thanks again, and have a good rest of your day.